வணக்கம் கிரீட்டிங்ஸ் டு ஆல் இந்தியன் ஃபாரஸ்ட் சர்வீஸ் ஆஸ்பிரன்ஸ் ஒன்ஸ் அகெயின் எ வார்ம் அண்ட் ஹார்ட்டி வெல்கம் டு ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ டு மை யூடியூப் சேனல் சில்வா எ லேடர் டு ரீச் கேனபி லாஸ்ட் செஷன் இட் வாஸ் அபவுட் த சிலபஸ் ஓவர்வியூ ஆஃப் சில்விகல்ச்சர் ஜெனரல் சில்விகல்ச்சர் சிம்பிளி த கல்டிவேஷன் ஆஃப் ஃபாரஸ்ட் கிராப்ஸ் த ட்ரீஸ் குரோயிங் இன் த ஃபாரஸ்ட் ஏரியா ஹேஸ் டு அண்டர்கோ டிஃபரெண்ட் ஸ்டேஜஸ் பிஃபோர் அல்டிமேட்லி இட் ரீச்சஸ் த லெவல் ஆஃப் ஹார்வெஸ்டிங் Some of the stages in the forest are establishment stage, development stage, and reproduction stage. So the trees undergo all these stages before reaches the harvesting stage. So the techniques or the application helps in maintaining all these stages are collectively known as silviculture. Or in simple terms, the techniques helps in regenerating the forest crop by artificially or natural means is also known as silviculture. So today we are going to see about the silviculture system, which is the subsequent application of silviculture. So this we are going to see about what is silviculture system and how it is important in the forest area. There are various types of forest available in the country, and the techniques required for a particular forest type will not be equally applicable for another forest area. So the varying techniques helps in regenerating the forest area is known as silviculture systems, which varies from one forest type to another forest type. So I will explain or I will define silviculture system simply as the set of silviculture procedure applied in a given forest area by which the crop constituting the forest area are harvested, tended, and replaced by new crop of distinctive form, which is very simply defined as silviculture systems. So in other words, the planned silviculture treatment applied to the forest crop throughout its life, that is also known as silviculture systems. So in this chapter we will be studying about what is silviculture system and how it is related to the silviculture, and also about its significance, because application of silviculture systems varies from one forest to another forest type. After studying the basics of silviculture system, we will be studying about the classification of silviculture system, which is primarily based on two important factors. One is about the mode of regeneration, and second one is about the pattern of felling. In mode of regeneration, which is divided into two different types, one is the high forest and another one is the coppice forest, which means the trees growing in the forest after harvesting, how it is regenerated, whether it is through the seed forest or through the coppice forest. That is the mode of classification that is based on regeneration. In high forest system, the regeneration is taking place through the seeds or the seedlings. And in coppice forest, it is through the coppicing. So that is why the first classification is based on mode of regeneration. And second important classification is based on the pattern of felling, which can be further divided into clear felling system, shelterwood system, and selection system. Here, it is about the pattern of felling, whether the felling is concentrated on a particular area or throughout the area. In case of clear felling system, a different kind of felling pattern is followed, and other two systems also the different kind of or the different pattern of felling are followed. Let us see one by one. The first and foremost system in the clear felling system, that is the based on pattern of felling. In clear felling system, the all the trees growing in the given forest area will be felled in one go. So no trees are left except under the special circumstances. So here the felling is concentrated, no trees will be left. So this pattern is highly concentrated and it is applicable for a very short rotation species. And we will be studying in detail about this system and its significance and also about its demerits in the later sessions. After the clear felling system, the second important system is about the uniform shelterwood system, or simply the shelterwood system. Unlike the clear felling system, felling is not that much concentrated, but more than that of the selection system. Here, felling is concentrated to a particular area for a particular period. So the area is divided into four different groups, and every group of area will be harvested or treated in a given time. That is why the concentration is taking place in a particular period only. And the different age classes will be created as a result of this treatment. And followed by the last important system is about the selection system. Here the concentration is very, very low, means only few areas will be taken for the filling. That is why as I mentioned that it is a very low concentrated filling, and the selection is purely based on the size. So some of the best examples available in our country is the canopy lifting system of Andamans, where the pterocarpus trees are selected and filled based on its dimension. Means once the trees achieved the particular size based on its girth or diameter, the trees are selected and filled. So the only the few trees available in the particular area will be focused for harvesting. That is why the concentration is very, very low, and resultant will be the trees of mixed ages will be available in the forest area. So these are the three important selection system, sheltered system and clear felling system, which is primarily based on the pattern of felling, and each type of harvesting will give a different type of forest, maybe the age sizes or the age or size classes. So these details will be dealt in the future classes. And after the high forest system, we are studying about the copy system, which functions purely based on the coppicing. So there are few trees growing in the forest known as a good coppicer or the coppicing capacity, because this system completely taking into consideration of the coppicing capacity of the trees growing in the given area. So we'll be studying about what is coppice and about the coppy system also. Unlike the high forest system, which aims to regenerate the forest crop by seeds or by through the seeds, here after filling the stump will be used as a source of regeneration, that is the inviting the coppicing through adventitious buds. And we will be also studying about the suitability of the trees for the coppicing system. As I mentioned that not all the trees are the good coppices. Some of the best coppices available in our country are eucalyptus and similar species. And in coppice system, which is further divided into three different types based on the pattern of filling, one is about the simple coppice system, another one is about the coppice with standard system, and about the coppice with resource system. In simple coppice system, it is like or it is similar to the clear felling system, in which all the trees are felled and no trees are left out. So this is almost the same pattern of clear felling system, which is also known as simple coppy system. So only difference in that the regeneration is through the coppicing. And second important coppy system available here is the coppy with standard system. Here two type of trees are growing in a given area. One is known as overwood, another one is the coppice trees. In overwood, the trees are sourced based on the seeds. So there are two rotation system followed in this system. One is for the standards, another one is for the coppicing. So the standards age will be multiple rotation of the coppicing trees. So details will be deliberated in the future classes. And finally, about the coppice with resource system. So unlike the first and second system, here most of the trees will be retained for maybe production of maximum size, or to give or to afford protection against some of the adverse condition. So here the ultimate objective is to control the trees rather than the exploitative in nature. So all these techniques, its merits and demerits will be studied in detail in the future session. And after the coppice system, we will be studying about the conversion or the conversion system. There is an argument about whether conversion is a system or not, because this is not a exact or the perfect system, which is similar to any of the systems covered in the beginning. So we'll be studying about what is conversion. Conversion is the switching over from one system to another system. Suppose a particular area where clear felling system is followed, and there is a proposal or there is a intention to change from clear felling system to another system, this process is simply defined as a conversion. And why conversion is necessary? It is due to technological advancement, or maybe the better understanding of the crops, or the silviculture understanding of the trees research, or any things may be the reason for conversion. And once we find that the particular system is not suitable for a particular crop, then also it is better to do the conversion. So these are the various necessities of conversion, and also about the techniques of conversion and how exactly the conversion is taking place in the forest area. Because switching over from one type to or one system to another system is not that easy. So instead of taking the whole area, only the certain pockets or the certain part of the areas are selected, then slowly remaining areas will also be included in the new system. So we'll be studying about the conversion system, the necessity of conversion, and techniques of conversion. And finally, about the application part, that is the management of silviculture systems of temperate, subtropical, humid tropical, dry tropical, and coastal tropical forest, with special reference to plantation, choice of species, establishment and management of standards, enrichment methods, technical constraints, intensive mechanized methods, aerial seeding and thinning. So there are different forest groups are available in the country, as mentioned here, as temperate, like the southern wet temperate forest or the northern mountain temperate forest, and subtropical, in case the subtropical pine forest, and humid tropical, that is about the tropical wet evergreen forest, and the dry tropical, and coastal tropical forest like the littoral and swamp forest. So all these forest groups or the types require a particular type of silviculture system. So here we will be studying about the which of the silviculture system, as mentioned by me in the beginning, like clear felling system, shelter wood selection system, or the different coppicing system, which system will be suitable to a particular forest group based on or with the special reference to all those points mentioned here, will be covered with the practical examples. So this is about the salient features of silviculture system, and we will be studying about the in detail about all these contents mentioned by me or shared by me in the future. So, dear aspirants, that was about the salient features of silviculture system, the second most important subject after the silviculture general. And we will be studying in detail about each and every content narrated here with practical examples also. So, if you have any doubts or any queries, let me know in the comment section given below. And best wishes to all of you. Thank you very much, and thanks for listening. Silva. A ladder to reach canopy. Nandi Vanakkam.